Hi everybody! 여러분 안녕하세요. 코리안 빌리입니다. 자, 오늘은 특별 게스트를 모셔가지고 함께 진행을 해볼까 하는데요. 자, 닉을 모셔봤습니다.
네, 안녕하세요. 독일에서 온 닉이라고 합니다.
안녕하세요.
반갑습니다.
어떻게 지냈어요?
뭐 크리스마스 때는 되게 오랜만에 독일 갔다 왔고
아, 독일 갔다 왔고
그리고 얼마 전에 이사 가지고 좀 바빴는데 그거 말고 뭐
자 오늘은요 닉이 독일 사람이니까 독일어에 대한 그리고 영어에 대한 이야기 그리고 닉이 한국어를 공부한 이야기를 한번 해볼까 하는데 So let's now speak in English.
All right, right? Let's do this.
Yeah, I believe your English is also really nice.
Yeah, I think I would say I'm quite confident in my English. I mean, I know it's not perfect, but I mean, I'm still a foreigner, right? But I have no problems speaking, listening, reading, writing.
Right. So. How did you study English as a German? You studied English at school, right?
Yeah, I mean, obviously everybody studies right. English at school, right? But my mom really thought it's very important for us as kids, like me and my brother, that we properly learn English. So since we were really young, everybody loves Disney, right? She bought all those old Disney video cassettes, you know, right? When you still used a video recorder and they were all in English, like Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck and all that. It was all in English and I really loved Disney, right? So even though I didn't understand much at that time, I was watching it over and over again. So I think that's like kind of the start how I got into English.
So you naturally kind of like absorbed
I'm not really a person that sits down at home and studies, like learns vocabulary. That doesn't really work for me. So I'm like more about the interaction. So even in school, it was more for me like pay attention in class and don't do my homework at home. Like there's people that sleep in class and do their homework at home and that works for them. That doesn't work for me. So I pay attention in class. And don't really study. And then when I was 16 years old, I went to the US for a year. And I really think that helped.
Then how is like teaching style at German schools? Like 문제 열심히 풀고, memorize all the words?
I mean, we do have some assignments like that, but I think it's a lot different from Korea. Like Korea is more like about the solving the problem, learn for the test, get a good grade, right? In Germany, it's more about participation in class. So if the teacher asks you and you don't raise your hand, that's basically a minus point. The more you participate in class, the better your grade will be. Like the test is only 30% while the participation in class is 70%. So it's a lot more about the interaction. For example, the homework is to read a book in English and then we go into class and we talk about it in English, of course, and write a summary and then stuff like that, have a presentation about it or watch a movie in English. And then have discussions about the meaning of the movie all in English. So it's a lot more about, you could actually say it's like having daily activities in English in class. That is not that much about learning for the test, not that much learning about like how to get the good score. It's more about how to properly use English
and getting used
in an environment.
To that.
Yeah, exactly.
That's nice. Then what about Korean? You're an absolute foreigner.
Yeah, I'm
when it comes
an absolute
to Korean.
foreigner.
Right.
When it comes to Korean. I have not known Korean before I came to Korea, besides like some, you know, everybody starts off with the bad words.
So like for an alphabet user, maybe Korean is totally different language, right?
It is, yeah, it is. Then, the grammar, the word structure, the sentence structure.
Then how did you first start to learn Korean then?
So when I went to the US, it was an international high school. And I got really close with some Koreans, like made some friends. I was like so fascinated by your alphabet, by your way of writing. So I did not know any Korean when I came to Korea, but I knew how to read and write it because I was like, teach me that alphabet. So I was in America supposed to study English, but I was like learning the Korean alphabet. And then when I came to Korea, that helped a bit, but I was still very high. I was so confusing at the beginning. So I went to language school for a year.
In Korea?
Yeah, at Korea University.
Okay.
Like, as I said, the Korean system about learning is all about the studying. So that really gave me a hard time. I'm like, my parents did not support me with money. Like, even if they said they would, I was like, nah, I'm gonna handle this by myself. So basically, I had to work at the same time. So I tried to work in a Korean environment to get what I learned from class and use it with Koreans that do not speak English. And even if they do, if like a Korean friend of mine that I know from America came was like trying to speak English to me, I'm like, no. You gotta speak Korean with me. Otherwise, wow. I'm not gonna learn it.
So you had to speak in Korean.
Yeah, so I'm like try to adapt that I can get the interaction that I need to memorize the vocabulary, that I need to practice and get the confidence that I would able be able to speak the Korean that I wanted to speak.
Nice. Then now you can speak in three languages, right? German, English, and Korean?
Yes.
That's so amazing.
And probably my German is the worst out of all three right now because I never use it.
Yeah, you don't use German anymore in Korea. Only English in Korean.
Only when
I
call my mom.
My gosh. Then what do you think was the most effective way when it comes to learning a foreign language? Just talking or watching TV shows?
Yeah, I think it is being in an environment where you don't have a choice. You know, like babies when they get born and they don't speak, right? They have no choice but to learn the language their parents speak because they have to communicate, right? So if you come to a country speaking German and English, but not everybody speaks German and English here, you have no choice. If you want to communicate with people, you have to learn the language. Like subconsciously, your concentration goes like very high without knowing it. So when you, wherever you go, like even if you go to 7-Eleven, right? And you want to get that Pringles chips over there or whatever. You concentrate so much more on what you say and how the person that works there answers that you absorb it like way faster than you normally would. Being in an environment where you don't have a choice.
Like your workplace, you had no choice but speaking in Korean.
닉은 독일 사람이에요. 독일 어디서 왔어요, 근데?
저 함부르크에서 태어나고 쭉 함부르크에서 살다가.
함부르크. 제가 얘기를 들은 게 있는데 이 독일 사람들은 영어를 되게 잘하는데 잘하는 이유가 독일어하고 영어하고 되게 비슷한 언어라서 자연스럽게 영어를 잘한다는 얘기 들었었어요.
비슷한 첨태가 많아요. 약간 그리고 거기서 제일 중요한 점은 아마도 약간 한국말로 그 말 어떻게 하는지 잘 모르는 roots, the roots of the language. 그거는 West Germanic, West Germanic. Like, so basically they are from the same language family, which would mean like if you have Spanish, French, like Italian, their dad is basically Latin, right?
Right.
So that's the same for German and English. They have the same parents, so to say.
Like they share the same language parents.
Exactly.
Okay. Then there must be some German words which look almost same as the English words. So
yeah, there's some words and only the pronunciation is different. For example, let's say something really easy. For example, bus.
Bus.
Bus. You would, that's the English word. You spell it B-U-S. And in German it is bus. Which you spell B-U-S. It's just the pronunciation that is different.
Just so the same spelling?
Yeah, it's the same spelling.
Ah, okay. But you don't say like bus? Is it bus?
It's bus, yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then we have family. And in Germany we have Familie. Which sounds really similar too, right? But you spell it different.
Oh, okay. And I also know there's a house.
Yeah, that is all actually the same pronunciation and the spelling is different. So it's house, and in German it's Haus. But the German spelling is H A U S, while the English pronunciation, the English spelling is H O U S E, right?
Yeah, and also beer is the same pronunciation.
Yeah, but the spelling is different.
Right? Is it B I E R?
Exactly.
Okay. So I think German and English people can somehow communicate with each other.
Yeah, and the grammar is really similar too.
Like the word order is almost same, isn't it?
Yeah, the sentence structure is the same.
Like I am German.
Ich bin Deutsch.
Oh, I can kind of like get that.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. Oh, that's interesting. So do you actually think that you could learn English very easily because you knew German?
Yeah, I think that's a good point. Like, there's like most Germans speak proper English and the only problem is like there's one thing that a lot of Americans or British people make fun of the Germans which is the pronunciation because when we have like the lots of Germans say the you know maybe you have heard about that some of you have German friends and you can directly hear he's a German because of the pronunciation but besides that like if you speak English and you want to travel to Germany you would like almost nowhere you would have any problem to communicate with people.
That's interesting. So what about some more basics like 1, 2, 3?
1, 2, 3.
That's wow. Simple. What about greetings?
Good morning in English, and we have Guten Morgen.
Right, Guten Morgen.
So it's also this, it's like, it sounds similar, right? Like to some extent.
What about hello?
Hallo.
Hallo. That's similar.
That's very similar, yeah.
What about bye?
That's different. We say tschüss.
Ah, okay. They are quite similar in some way, but
yeah, then the other hand is like very different.
It's really mixed. That's quite confusing. And I also heard that there are some German words which are also used in English.
Oh yeah, there are some. Like, right. For example, I actually think there's some that are used in other languages as well. For example, mm-hmm. Kindergarten in German, kindergarten. It's Kindergarten.
Ah, okay.
And you spell it the same. It's basically just a German word. Same as like, Doppelgänger.
Yeah, Doppelgänger.
Which Japanese people love for their animations and stuff, right? And actually, now that I think about it, there is a Korean word which is a German word, actually. Can you guess?
What?
Alba, basically.
Right.
The German word Arbeit means to work.
Ah, right. Arbeit.
Yeah, that's the German word.
So, like, English speakers don't really say Arbeit or something like that.
No, they don't say that, but Koreans say it, which I think is kind
of funny. That's interesting. Why did Korean people get that word from German?
And I think it's funny because Koreans use it for part-time work, right?
Right.
But basically, it just means to work.
Right. That's interesting.
I think another point why especially like English and German is like really mixed is because Europe is so close. You know, there's so many countries in that small space. So we use like, even though we have our own German words, mm-hmm. like especially younger people use some English words just because mm-hmm. they think it's cool. For example, let's say cool, we use that because we think it's cool.
Ah, okay.
And also there's French words, which mm-hmm. like almost every country in Europe uses. For example, toilet, it's basically a French word. In German, it's toilette.
Mm.
It's spelled the same as in English, toilet. And it's basically a French word, right?
Right. Then, like Korean people, they kind of get really worried when they try to go to Germany.
Yes.
So, can Korean people communicate with German people in English?
Yes. Like, there's no problem.
Are most of the German people quite good at English then?
I would say so. Like the older generation.
Mm-hmm.
They are like, there's still a generation that is born like after the war. So these people might have some problems communicating in English. But if you speak to people like 30, 40s, like there's like almost no one that would not be able to communicate.
Mm.
And that's one good thing. It's like, I think it's kind of sad that Korea has that 영어 공포.
Mm-hmm.
But in Germany, we don't have that. So
there's no like 영어 학원 in Germany.
No, we don't even have 학원s at all.
Oh, okay.
Like, I was really surprised when I came to Korea and they were like,
Hakons. So many Hakon, yeah. Then, like, is German only used in Germany? Is there any other country which use German?
Switzerland uses German.
Oh, okay.
And Austria uses German in a very different accent.
Oh, right. So I've never studied German before, but I'm kind of like getting interested in German because
you
it sounds
try.
Yeah, because it sounds quite easy for me now. So we've been talking about Nick's story about learning English, Korean, and German and English relationship. So it's really interesting to know about German and English relationship.
Maybe I can teach you sometime.
Right, definitely. So lastly, could you say goodbye to the viewers?
Let me start in Korean first.
Okay.
일단 오늘 불러줘서 너무 감사하고요. 재밌게 봤으면 좋겠고 또 히로에 대해서 조금 알게 됐으면 아니면 배우는 생각하지 들었으면은 너무 너무 좋았을 건데 너무 어려운데 안 하면 저도 이해해요. 그래서 또 히로에 대해서 더 많이 알고 싶으면은 빌리한테 댓글 많이 달아주시고 나중에 아마 다시 나올 수도 있어요.
Right.
감사합니다. And then in German, mm-hmm. what should I say?
Then I'll speak in English sentence
okay.
and you change it into like German.
Oh,
okay?
I'm going to be a translator.
Right, interpreter. So I had a great time.
Ich hatte eine super Zeit.
And I hope to see you guys again.
Und ich hoffe, dass ich euch alle wiedersehe.
Thank you so much.
Vielen, vielen Dank.
Wow. And bye.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Oh, wow. That's really confusing.
I know, right?
And
I follow my YouTube.
Right. Time to promote your YouTube channel.
I forgot. I hope he puts my YouTube channel link in the description if you have any more interest in my life. Maybe I'm gonna teach some German. I'm not sure yet though, but make sure you check it out. I would really appreciate it.
Yes. What is the name of your YouTube channel?
It's just my name, Nicholas Klabunde.
Okay, so do not forget to subscribe to his channel as well and have a look at his amazing videos.
Just trying, I'm still learning.
I think that's it for today and I'll see you guys next time. And if you like this video, don't forget to click thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel as well. This one. And I'll see you guys next time. What's again? Bye.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen?
Yes. Oh, your pronunciation is very good.
Thank you. So, 3, 2, 1.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Bye.
Bye bye.